Good afternoon, everyone. I hope you're all doing well. Back today with another video. How do you talk about your holidays? How do you talk about what happened last weekend? How do we talk about the past? Today we're going to learn about it. I'm going to teach you all about the past simple, all its uses, spelling. It's just exactly the same as all the other tenses videos we've made so far, and I hope you learned something. So let's just get straight into it. So there's two types of past simple verbs in the positive form. We've got regular and irregular. Now, the regular form takes an ed ending. It must be mentioned that there are three ed ending sounds. One of them is d, one of them is t, and one of them is ed. I'm not going to explain them in this video because it'll take too long. I'm simply going to put the spelling rules of regular ed verb endings on screen for you now. Other than that, the past simple can take an irregular form. Go would be went, take is took, have is had. Yeah, these don't take the ed verb endings, so they must be remembered and learned. There's no rules, there's no set rules for them, so you must learn them by heart. The negative form, however, is really, 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 really simple. In the present simple video we did, I'll leave it in the top of your screen if you want to go and check it out. We did don't and doesn't for negative forms. That don't and doesn't is simply didn't in past simple. Didn't plus the infinitive form. Again, it's on screen for you. Take a mental note, take a screenshot, you know the score. Past simple questions, again, it's relatively simple. Do and the does that we used in the present simple video simply changes to did. Again, it's on screen, everything's there. We're not gonna talk about it for too long. You can take the notes away with you and we can just get straight into the uses. Just before we continue, the thing about the past simple to remember is that's the normal go-to past form we use if there's no other reason to use any of the other past forms. This is the one we normally use. First of all, we have past simple for short, completed, finished actions. They started in the past, they finished in the past, they're not connected with now. We move on. That's the past simple in its simplest form. Yesterday I met my friend, we had lunch, we talked, and we went home. That's it in its simplest form. The second use of past simple is with finished time expressions. Time expressions in the past, that's your last. So last week, last month, last year, last Christmas, last February. Anything with last, that's past simple because it's finished. This time expression, this time phrase, is finished. Also ago, 2 years ago, 3 years ago, 2 minutes ago even, because it's finished. We've moved on. The day before yesterday, yesterday. Past simple. Remember those time phrases because they're essential when you use the past simple. And we move on to repeated actions. I knocked on the door 4 times. I don't know if you heard that. I knocked on the door 4 times before he answered. It's a repeated action. Your car breaks down. I tried to start it 6 times before it finally started moving again. Past simple, repeated actions. Another way to use the past simple is to talk about details of the news. For example, your title might be in the present perfect, which is a tense we're going to discuss pretty soon. Yeah, 3 men have been found dead in a shabby old house in North London, right? When we want to give more details about that news, we would continue in the past simple. 3 men were found this morning at 2 p.m. with stab wounds in their heart. Police arrived at 6 o'clock, took some fingerprints, took some DNA tests. The first thing you heard was the present perfect to give you the title. Then we continue the story in the past simple. That way is also used when we ourselves give details about experiences. Someone asks, have you been to Mount Everest? Again, this is present perfect, it's in another video. Have you been to Mount Everest? Yes, I have. When you give more details, you don't continue using the present perfect. You have to use the past simple. Even the person asking the questions, when did you go? Who were you with? What did you do there? What was the weather like? These are all past simple questions. So we need to answer in past simple. So details of news, details of experiences, okay? Next up is actions that happen in chronological order, one after another. This morning, I woke up at 6 o'clock. I washed my face and I went downstairs. I had breakfast, I spoke with my mum. I turned on the TV, watched it for a little while, and then went back upstairs. I got dressed, then I took the bus to work. I took the tram to work. Can you see? All these are in a logical order and we just use past simple to describe them. So anytime you want to tell a story or a description of what your morning was like or what your weekend was like, you use past simple for that. We move on to duration in the past. So with a word like for, And it doesn't even matter how long. It could be for 1 minute, it could be for 10 minutes, it could be for 20 years. This is not really about me, but as an example, I lived in Italy for 20 years. Yeah, it's a past simple expression. It's a past simple phrase. It was 20 years. It's a long action, but it started in the past and it finished in the past. It's not connected with now. That's the main aspect of the past simple. We move on. It's not connected to the present, so we just move on. Past simple is used in other structures that I will not explain today, because these are the ones that you need. The ones I've spoken about today are the ones you need. We can use them in conditional sentences. Those are going to be in another video, so stay tuned to catch them. And they're also used in more advanced structures to even talk about the future. They will be in another video for you, and we'll add them as the channel continues to grow. Guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. I hope you took something away from it. Like the video, subscribe, share, comment. You know what to do. Have a nice day, and we'll catch you in the next video. See you later.